What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating an Intune policy to add a local user into the admin group. So let's get right into it. All right, so today's a super simple one, and the first thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on Show All, and we are going to locate and click on Microsoft Intune. So go for it. Locate it. Click on it. Yes, it's going to take you here. So we are actually going to locate Endpoint Security. So click on that, and it should take you here. Now, underneath Manage, we are going to locate Account Protection. So locate it and then click on it. We've created one policy a long time ago, and that was dealing with Windows Lapse, which is awesome. We are going to be creating a new policy today together. So there's a button right there. We're going to click on Create Policy. So click on that, and you're going to get a side menu. For the platform, we are going to click on the dropdown, and we only have one option, so let's select Windows. And for the profile, again, there's a dropdown, so click on it, and you have three options. Now, the option that we are going to be configuring would be Local User Group Membership, so click on it. Nice. So all the way in the bottom, we are going to click on Create, and it is time for us to give our policy a name. I'm going to provide the following, pretty self-explanatory, and at the very bottom, let's click on Next, and it's time for us to configure the settings. So we are going to click on Add, and as soon as you click on Add, it is going to give you four columns. Now, the first column is your local group, so we're going to click on the dropdown, and by default, it is going to select administrators. You are able to configure it the way that you want it. You also have the option to add this particular user within the remote desktop users group, which is pretty awesome. Now let's head over to the second column, which is group and user action. And these are the three options that you have. I'm going to just leave it as the default, which is add. And let's go to the third column, which is user selection type. And we're going to do user and group. And the last column is basically selecting your user or group. So click on that link, which is a hyperlink, and it's going to give you a side menu. Now, I'm actually going to enter Bernardo Orocho, this account, into the administrative group. Once you select your user or group, click on select, and you're done. This configuration for me would be I'm adding Bernardo.Orocho into the administrative group. I'm adding it into that group. Okay. Once you're done, we're going to click on next. For tags, I typically don't add any tags. Microsoft was nice enough to create one for me, so I leave it as is. I'm going to click on next. And for assignments, I'm going to type in BTNHD, and I am going to select devices and testing only. And I'm going to click on next. A nice little review. And let's click on save. And on the upper right-hand side, you're going to see save assignments. Policy was created. Give it some time. And there goes our new account protection policy. Cool, right? And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.